Hi, gang. It's me, Movie Bob, and this week on The Big Picture, I'm gonna blow your mind. Last year, geek culture lost a valuable voice. Dwayne McDuffie, who over the course of a far, far too short career made a huge impact on the world of comics and animation, passed away at only 49 years old. Today, I'm here to tell those of you who may not have heard of it before about one of his most interesting contributions to nerd culture, the Tommy Westfall Universe Hypothesis. Okay, let me back up. In 2002, McDuffie wrote an editorial for Slush Factory arguing that comic books ought to stop being so strict about inter-series continuity, asking that fans stop for a moment and consider just how insane things would get if other mediums treated their continuity with the same rigidity. As an example, he cited Saint Elsewhere, a well-regarded 1980s television drama set at a hospital. Saint Elsewhere was a good show and popular in its time, but today it's mostly remembered for having one of the all-time endings in TV history. In the final moments of the final episode, it was revealed that the hospital and all of its characters had never existed. In fact, the entire show had taken place in the imagination of Tommy Westfall, an autistic child who had been one of the Doctor's sons on the series.
TV is weird!
Here's where McDuffie's issue came in. See, Saint Elsewhere had actually crossed over with other contemporary and prior television series, and if TV worked the same way comics did, that would mean that all of those shows, and any show they'd somehow touched, would also have to be figments of Tommy Westfall's imagination. And wouldn't that just be ridiculous? And then, the internet being the internet, people decided to actually start charting out how far the so-called Westfall universe continuity would actually stretch. And what they found, and continue to find, is that Dwayne McDuffie was even more right than he knew. Not only does a lot of TV seemingly take place in Tommy Westfall's head, it's starting to look like almost all of TV is in there. Example, two of what turned out to be the Westfall boys' imaginary characters from Saint Elsewhere appeared on the crime drama Homicide: Life on the Street, making Homicide just part of Tommy's fantasy too. Homicide, in turn, featured a character named John Munch, played by Richard Belzer, who later emigrated to the Law & Order series, so you can add that whole galaxy of shows as well, along with The Wire, where Munch also appeared, and the BBC's Luther, where he's name-checked as an American liaison. Oh, and he turned up on The X-Files, meaning that Tommy also imagined Millennium, The Lone Gunman, and The Simpsons, which in turn means that The Critic and King of the Hill, yep, they're in there too, and so are 24 and possibly Dragnet. Oh, but it gets weirder, and it's not just through Homicide either. Saint Elsewhere also did a crossover with Cheers. Cheers spun off into the series Frasier, which did a brief crossover of its own with the John Larroquette show. That show makes reference to a powerful corporation called Yoyodyne. Does that sound familiar? Well, Yoyodyne is actually a reference to Thomas Pynchon's book The Crying of Lot 49, and it's a reference a lot of genre writers like to make. Example, the Yoyodyne Corporation is a client of Wolfram and Hart from Angel, so the Buffyverse? Actually a mere part of Tommy Westfall's massive daydream mythology. Oh, and Yoyodyne is also mentioned as having manufactured starship parts on Star Trek The Next Generation, which in turn places it, the original series, Deep Space Nine, Voyager, Enterprise, all the movies, and the alternate J.J. Abrams timeline right in there. Got room for one more? Okay, going back to Angel for a minute, Wolfram and Hart had another corporate client in Weyland-Yutani. Now that's a pretty big reference in and of itself because it means Tommy Westfall also conjured up the Aliens and Predator series and Firefly, but a Weyland-Yutani cruiser was among the wreckage once glimpsed in a spaceship graveyard by the crew of Red Dwarf. You know what other easily recognizable mode of sci-fi transportation was once seen in the background of Red Dwarf? Yup. Tommy Westfall, the true progenitor of all 11 Doctors, and everything they have ever touched. Hell, thanks to the dual 1990s trends of classic TV characters reviving their roles in cameos and network-wide crossovers, the Westfall universe also encompasses Alf, Alias, Ally McBeal, Mork and Mindy, Arrested Development, Home Improvement, Boston Legal, all three CSIs, Degrassi, Drew Carey, Hangin' with Mr. Cooper, Family Matters, Happy Days, I Dream of Jeannie, The Brady Bunch, Leave It to Beaver, The Addams Family, and The Munsters, The Fresh Prince, Friends, Full House, Erie, Indiana, MASH, Seinfeld, Moesha, Knight Rider, and Walker, Texas Ranger. In total, the attempts to chart out Tommy Westfall's mind often yield nearly 300 shows, and counting. Now, this is a fun game, to be sure, but the question remains, does all of this prove Dwayne McDuffie's original point about continuity? Well, yes and no, in my opinion. On the one hand, yes, there's a lot of shows in this theoretical multiverse that would lose a lot of their own intended weight and meaning if they were suddenly decided to be part of other shows with more irreverent or fantastical bent, but on the other hand, a lot of TV fans have clearly gotten a lot of enjoyment out of hunting down and cataloging these Westfall connections. So, who's to say? Oh, and speaking of people cataloging this stuff, lest you think that I pulled all this off the top of my head, the research for this episode was checked against and improved immeasurably by the meticulous chart-making efforts of the Tommy Westfall's Mind live journal maintained by one Keith Gow. I'm Bob, and that's the big picture.